difficult enough to keep on top of your competitors down here on Earth when you run a hotel, especially since you can find hotels almost anywhere these days. However, very soon, a newer, more advanced hotel will make a play in the game for ultimate bragging rights by opening its doors in space. You heard that right. We can now plan our very own honeymoon or getaway outside of Earth, because the world's first space hotel will soon become a reality. Space enthusiasts and aspiring space travelers can have an interstellar experience, as the space hotel is expected to be fully operational by the year 2027. How'd this crazy idea start? Who's brave enough to take on such a high expectation, costly, and revolutionary project? Well, sit back and get comfy, because in today's video, we'll find out. But before we start, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for more awesome videos like this. Now, let's get into it. This ambitious venture will be constructed by none other than the Orbital Assembly Corporation, an organization established by the Gateway Foundation. The Orbital Assembly Corporation was made as a method for advancing plans to colonize space. It's certainly a huge step towards a future of traveling and living in space, even if the Voyager Station may not be a permanent colony. They're currently driven to finish the development and construction of the hotel, and will soon be catering to adventurous space travelers by the year 2027. The commercial space station is expected to accommodate around 400 people. According to reports, these will be composed of 112 crew members and 280 guests. The original idea for the Voyager Station, which was previously called the Von Braun Station, was announced in 2019 with a planned launch date of 2027. Like other business establishments, the global pandemic, as well as construction delays, had unfortunately set the hotel's construction back and has since been taken over by the new construction organization, the Orbital Assembly Corporation, or OAC. Presently, the Orbital Assembly Corporation's president, John Blinkow, is a former pilot who's educated, motivated, and optimistic that lodging on a space station in this era is not only possible but very likely. Although many would anticipate the Voyager Station to be in the same style as in the movie 2001 A Space Odyssey, Tim Elator, the Orbital Assembly Corporation's senior designer, made a guarantee that it wouldn't be the case, and it was a guide on what to avoid when it came to the hotel's aesthetic. The wheel-shaped space hotel is said to be furnished with restaurants, rock climbing walls, an entertainment center, a basketball court, and even a cinema. It's planned to be built in low Earth orbit, as disclosed by the Orbital Assembly Corporation on January 29, 2021, in its YouTube live stream entitled First Assembly. The concept of the 650-foot-wide space hotel is to have it move with a high angular velocity to produce levels of artificial gravity similar to the moon to acclimate its inhabitants and guests. 24 living modules that are 20 meters long and 12 meters wide are what the hotel will be composed of, and will pivot on itself to create an artificial gravity that will permit its guests to stand and do normal activities. The artificial gravity in the hotel will be the same level of gravity that's found on the moon, which is about 1/6 of the gravity found here on Earth. At an altitude of 1,900 kilometers, the Voyager station will go around the Earth every 1.5 hours. Can you imagine the speed it will take to complete each orbit? As for the Voyager Station's crew, it will incorporate a group of space tourists, service industry experts, and of course, scientists conducting research in case there are any problems encountered at the space hotel. They'll also be researching how to improve its current procedures, facilities, and technology. However, getting into the Voyager Station is no walk in the park, because these space tourists and crewmates are required to undergo the proper training and preparation first before they can call themselves the first people to stay at a space hotel. There are concerns on how humans can become acclimated to the environment in space, and whether they'll be able to function normally as if they're on Earth. The Orbital Assembly Corporation has that covered and will be planning to have the Voyager Station rotate to create man-made gravity since the hotel won't have it in space. This will permit space vacationers to still be able to eat normally, sleep soundly, and enjoy the hotel's furnishings as close to normal as possible. According to a report, another reason to create artificial gravity is so that visitors will not experience moon face, which is the unwanted effect of microgravity on the body's distribution of fluid. Fun fact, jumping in the Voyager space station means jumping 5 times higher on Earth, John Blinkow stated his guests will be in fake gravity, which is similar to that on the moon. Besides allowing visitors to appreciate and enjoy the once-in-a-lifetime experience of space travel, for quite an enormous fee, they can likewise hope to be served food from the very best chefs on the planet, as well as attend concerts from renowned entertainers and talents such as Beyoncé, Sting, and many more. Space travelers and vacationers can also anticipate being able to spacewalk, an experience only cosmonauts and astronauts have had the option to do ever since humans figured out how to venture into space. Taking into account the proposed time frame, can the project be pulled off? With a project this big, it's hard to believe that the structure will be completely finished within the proposed time frame. Based on an article on the Space Hotel Project in New Atlas, it proposes that the Voyager Station will cost tens of billions of dollars to build and develop. Those are estimates, since the operating expenses are obscure as of now, but the Voyager Station is expected to have a staff of around 112, as well as the occasional performer to entertain the guests, as mentioned earlier. Apparently, it will cost an aspiring space vacationer $5 million for a 3.5-day stay at the Space Hotel. Hopefully, the cost will go down as the years pass by to make the hotel more accessible to the public. It's no surprise that the 6-year planned schedule for constructing a hotel in space is aspiring yet difficult, especially considering the scale and size of the Voyager space station. To demonstrate its semi-automatic robotic construction technology, the organization expects to deploy a small-scale prototype that's 40 meters in diameter first. If that's been accomplished, the organization will then continue to build the full-scale model. All things considered, the Orbital Assembly Corporation should raise the huge amount of funds needed to construct and develop the Voyager Station Space Hotel, beat the multitude of technical problems posed by executing such a big venture, and then get back the money and continue to generate profits from it. In the event that the organization can accomplish all of those things, it will have turned what was once just a work of fiction into, arguably, the most impressive man-made structure ever built. And there you go. Thanks to ambitious, big-talking, aspiring billionaires and great minds such as Elon Musk and Richard Branson, we're living in a time where huge technological and cosmic promises can be made without batting an eye. So it should not shock the average Joe that Gateway Foundation is focusing on aiming for the space hotel's completion as early as the year 2025. Regardless of what year or decade it happens, commercial space travel and tourism will likely be a reality and even become normal sooner than the majority of us anticipate. As Tim Alator, the Voyager Station's senior design architect, said, "Eventually, going to space will be just another option people will pick for their vacation, just like going on a cruise or going to Disney World." And we can't wait for that to happen. Do you want to be a space tourist? What would you do on your first day at the Voyager Station? Let us know in the comment section down below. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.